This is your question number 3. Diagonals of a square IJKL. So this square is already made on your screen. Intersect, diagonals intersect at point M. Find the measure of angle IMJ. So we're talking about, the question talks about this angle IMJ. This is IMJ. This angle should be 90 degree because diagonals perpendicular bisector of each other. We know that. So how we can write this? Quadrilateral IJKL is a square. This is already given in given. If it is a square, then we can say that angle IMJ is of 90 degree. Reason you can give as diagonal bisect each other, a perpendicular bisector of each other. So diagonals of a square are perpendicular bisector of each other. Now next part of the question says find out angle JIK. So JIK, this one, this is JIK. So here angle JIL or angle I is of 90 degree. We know that each angle of a square is of 90 degree. So if angle I is of 90 degree, then we can say angle JIK is half of angle I because diagonals bisect the opposite angles. So here we can give this reason: diagonals of a square bisect opposite angles. So that is the reason this JIK is actually half of angle I. Now angle JIK is half of angle I, that is 90 degree. So this way we can say angle JIK is 45 degree. Now next and last part of this question is to find out angle LJK. So LJK, this angle, similarly we can prove that angle LJK is also 45. So you don't need to write this procedure again. The same procedure we can follow to say that this angle is also 45 degree. So we're not going to repeat the same procedure. You just need to write similarly angle LJK is also 45 degree because LJK is actually half of angle J and angle J is of 90 degree because it is one of the angle of the square and LJ is diagonal. which bisects both the opposite angles, that is L as well as J. Hope it is clear. This is your solution now for this question number 3. This is question number 4. Diagonals of a rhombus are 20 cm and 21 cm respectively. So these are length of the diagonals, 20 and 21 cm. Find the sides of the rhombus. We need to find out sides of the rhombus and its perimeter. So this is all about this question. Now, quadrilateral ABCD is a rhombus. This is already given. So here we will mention that quadrilateral ABCD is a rhombus. First, AC and BD are joined together and they are diagonal. So I can consider, let diagonals intersect in point O. So O is point of intersection for both the diagonals. In triangle, here, if diagonals intersect each other, we can consider this angle as a right angle. So here we can mention that diagonal AC is shorter diagonal, which can be assumed as 20 cm, and diagonal BD is longer one, so BD can be considered as 21 cm. So these are two diagonals of the rhombus. Here I can say angle AOD is of 90 degree and AO half of AC. So this should be half of 20, which is 10. And DO is half of BD. So half of BD, that is half of 21. So it will be 10.5 cm. And for these three statements, we can use same reason. Diagonals are perpendicular bisector of each other. If they are perpendicular, they will make 90 degree angle at the point of intersection, and diagonals will be divided into two equal parts. So here we can mention diagonals are perpendicular bisector of each other. So this is our reason for all three statements. Now I'll take triangle AOD in triangle ADO. Angle AOD is of 90 degree. So we can use Pythagoras theorem. Here we can say AD square is equals to AO square plus DO square by Pythagoras theorem. Now, AD we need to calculate, so here we will write AD square. AO is actually 10 centimeters, so here we can take 10 square. DO is 10.5, so here I can take 10.5 centimeter square. So 10 square, that is 100, plus 10.5 square. Just multiply 10.5 with 10.5. Mic on mute. So 10.5 square is 110.25. Here we have calculation. We made the calculation. So AD square is actually 100 plus 110 will give me 210.25. So this is AD square. We need length of AD. So length of AD we can calculate. So for that we need square root of 210.25. Just a minute. Yes. Yes. So here we need to find out square root of 210.25. So what I can do, I can group, you know how to find out square root. I'll just show you. Before decimal we have three digits, so we can categorize them like this, and after decimal we can categorize 2, 5 together. So a first number is 2. I need a perfect square, so here I can take 1 ones are 1, and this 1 we can copy here. So 1 plus 1 will give me 2, and here we will subtract 2 minus 1, that is 1. So here next set of number is 110, so I'll copy 110 here. Then I need a number which I'll add up here. So I'm taking 4. So I'll add 4 here. Here. Then we will multiply 24 by 4. So 4 4s are 16. 1 will carry out. 4 2s are 8 plus 1, 9. 96. Here we can add and here we can subtract. So 4 plus 4 will give me 8. And 110 minus 96, so I left with 14. So here we have 14. Then next set of number is 25, that is 25. So I'll copy 25 here. And here we can take decimal, because before 25 we have decimal sign. So here I'll take decimal. Then we need to add a number along with this 28. So I'll prefer to take 5, because when you multiply this 285 with 5, you will get 1425. So here we will multiply with 5 itself, because we are adding 5. So when you add 5 here, same 5 we can write on the top. So 5 5s are 25, 2 will carry, 5 8s are 40 plus 2, 42, 4 will carry, 5 2s are 10 plus 4, 14. So 285 into 5 will give you 1425. Here we can subtract, here we can add. So 5 plus 5, that is 10, 8 plus 1, 9, and it is 2. And this will become 0, and this is your square root. 14.5. So length of AD is 14.5. If length of AD is 14.5, so here we can say that AD is same as AB, is same as BC, and AD, BC, AB, and CD. all four sides are equal and each is of 14.5 centimeter. Now next part of the question was about find the perimeter. Perimeter of rhombus A, B, C, D. Since it is a rhombus, so we can say perimeter is 4 into side. So 4 into length of the side is 14.5. So we just need to multiply 14.5 with 4 to get our final answer, that is perimeter of this rhombus. 4 5s are 20, so we will take 0, and before decimal we don't write 0, right? So 2 will carry forward. 4 4s are 16 plus 2, that is 18. 1 will carry. 4 1s are 4 plus 1, 5. 58 centimeter. Perimeter of this rhombus is 58 centimeter. And this is your solution. Anybody have any question, query it out, you can